Did you know that the father of Protestantism, the father of the Protestants, Martin Luther, said that the book of Hebrews, the book of James, the book of Jude, and the book of Revelation should not be in the Bible? Yeah, that's right. I mean, isn't that shocking? I met with an old friend of mine a few years ago. So he's a pastor in a nearby city. And so he called me and he said, you know, I would like to meet up with you. How about we meet at a coffee shop? I said, sure. So I met with him in a coffee shop. He brought a friend of his with him. I mean, I guess for support. I mean, after all, you're meeting with me, right? So he brought a friend with him. And he was talking about how he wants me to basically come under the umbrella of his denominational church and to plant a church and for me to be a pastor of a church. And so, you know, I can't really see myself being a pastor of a mainline denominational church. But, you know, I listened to what he had to say. And of course, we started talking about theology. Well, this guy is a Protestant. A Protestant of Protestants, okay? And one of the topics that I brought up is every word of the Bible God's word for us today, okay? Is every word of the Bible God's word for us today? Now, of course, being a Protestant as he is, a very conservative evangelical Protestant pastor, he's like, yes, absolutely, every single word of the Bible, especially the New Testament, is God's word for us today. I said, well, you know, Paul, it was Paul speaking in his letters, okay? It wasn't Jesus himself that wrote that. It was Paul. And Paul wrote stuff like, go get my cloak at such and such a place, or go greet Aquila or Priscilla, and all these little personal details in Paul's personal letter to other people. And so I said to him, you know, that is not God speaking to you today, okay? If so, you better go find Aquila and Priscilla. You better go greet them, okay, right now. You better go find Paul's cloak right now, because Paul's going to be upset with you. Or should I say God's going to be upset with you, because that's God speaking to you today. And so, of course, he was getting really, really riled up, okay? This guy was getting really, really riled up. And so I also brought to his attention that Paul said himself in 1 Corinthians chapter 7 that not everything he's writing is actually God's commandment or God's word for you today, but rather it's Paul's own judgment on the matter. Now, at this point in time, this guy was getting really, really flustered. And that's not to mention the guy that he brought with him, okay? The guy that he brought with him was really shaken up. He was scared. He was literally so nervous, he was speaking in tongues, looking at me in the face, speaking in tongues. This is in a public place, in a coffee shop, everybody around, okay? And this guy's looking at me going, oh, he's looking me right in the eye, talking like this. I'm going, okay, well, okay, so let's talk about the Bible. And this guy's going, you know, I'm like, I'm just telling you what the Bible says. I'm just telling you what the Bible says about itself. And so I'm like, you guys are Protestant, right? They're like, yeah, we're Protestant. I'm like, well, do you realize that your father, the father of the Protestant Reformation, the father of Protestantism, said that the book of Hebrews, the book of James, the book of Jude, and the book of Revelation is not God's word, and that it should be taken out of the Bible? I said, how does that fit in with your theology of every single word of the Bible is God speaking to you today? And by this time, this guy was so upset. He was like, well, I'm Catholic. It's like, if you're to know this guy, okay, he's far from Catholic. It's just a Protestant pastor who really just didn't put a whole lot of thought into his own theology. Now, one last point. Even Martin Luther himself said that the Apocrypha should be read and studied by all Protestants because it is very profitable information in it. Now think about this for a second. Martin Luther put more credibility and more value on the Apocrypha than he did the books of Hebrews, James, Jude, and Revelation. Just something for you to think about next time you talk to your Protestant friends. Until next time, seek him with all your heart, and if you do, you will find him. Call upon him, and he will show you great and mighty things. Love you guys.